السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وأتم الحج والعمرة لله. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: الحج المبرور ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. My respected brothers and elders and sisters, by just the ayah and the hadith that I read, you probably guessed that what we will be talking about, and it may seem a little awkward to be talking about this at this moment, but it really is very relevant to talk about Hajj from now. We talked about it once before, after the Hajj applications had been closed, but now it is very relevant to talk about it. And first of all, remember this: having the virtues in front will motivate us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has commanded us. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. That is necessary for the sake of Allah upon the people to do Hajj of the Baytullah for those who have the ability to do so. And of course, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know in that famous hadith that the foundation of Islam is based on five pillars and five things. بُنِيَ الْإِسْلَامُ عَلَىٰ خَمْسِ. And one of them he mentioned, حَجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. To perform Hajj of the Baytullah, of the house of Allah, and of course with all these details, for those who have the ability to do so. And really remember this, if we really look at it, who is Hajj fard on? So many brothers and sisters, Hajj is not fard on them, so they don't get the chance to do Hajj. And it is not a sin on them, because they don't have the proper means to do that. And yes, of course, every single Muslim has the zeal and has that enthusiasm inside that I want to go. You know, even if I go for, I can go for a few days, I want to go and visit the house of Allah, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fulfill this great commandment of Allah, this great faridah, and one which something is described as a pillar of Islam, a foundation of Islam, and such that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us and commanded us, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has emphasized on it so much. So remember this, of course, but we need to realize that who it is necessary for. مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. Whoever has the mean to reach there. And of course, we talked about it before, and inshallah we'll repeat it again. And according to that, remember this, we really need to ponder over that what do we need to do. So of course, remember this, whichever Muslim who is a grown-up, who is baligh, who is sane, he's not out of his mind, he's not mad and crazy, he is sane, and he is grown up and he is healthy, he has the ability, he can go, he can bear all the hardships, and he can go, meaning he's not paralyzed, he's not such that the Hajj will cause him, or this traveling will cause him to become even sicker and worse in his health. And he has enough money to go and come back. And if he has people to take care of, he has family, or he has some ordinary or some responsibilities that he has enough money besides that he can take care of their needs as well. He can leave it for them. They also have that much amount that he can organize it in a way that he can leave money for them, and he has enough money to go. So whoever has that much amount, then Hajj is fard on him. And we mentioned, due to that, so many of our women, Hajj does not become fard on them. You know, just understand this point. Hajj is not fard on them. Yes, if the husband or the father of that grown-up child who has become baligha, that woman or that child wants to take him on his own expense, then their Hajj will be done. Then their Hajj will be done. It will be considered that they have fulfilled their fard Hajj. But it did not become fard on them, because they themselves did not own that amount. So that's why so many women is not fard on them. But yes, the husband out of kindness, then he said, okay, I also want to take you. Or the father sometimes he said, I want to take my grown up children. which if he can, it is a good thing. You know, alhamdulillah, a person Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given so much that he can not just bear the expenses for himself, he can bear the expenses for everyone in his family, those that have grown up. So for that, my brothers, since time is very short and we don't have much, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us, and brothers, this is a pillar of Islam. So brothers, looking at this, these conditions, if we really look into our lives, or we look around, if I have performed Hajj, alhamdulillah, we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I have the ability to do so again, of course that is not fard anymore, that will be enough al Hajj. But of course the rewards are great. And what are the great rewards? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Al-Hajjul Mamroor laysa lahu jazaun illa al-Jannah. That the Hajj Mamroor, a Hajj that is accepted in the eyes of Allah, a righteous Hajj, that the only reward that a person gets is that he will go to Jannah. Meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the reward cannot be calculated, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him in Jannah. And according to many ahadith, a person's sins are forgiven. مَنْ حَجَّ فَلَمْ يَرْفُثُ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ رَجَعَكَ يَوْمٍ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ. A person who performs Hajj in such a way that he does not engage in any obscene activity, any useless talk and something that is not supposed to talk. And there's a lot of detail to that. And he does not do any other sins that he's not supposed to do that. وَلَمْ حَجَّ فَلَمْ يَرْفُثْ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ رَجَعَ. And according to some the ayat in the Quran, that he does not engage in fighting and argument. He doesn't argue with others, because this is such a journey of hardships, and a person has to bear. He will have companions with him. They will sometimes be hot, sometimes his needs will not be fulfilled. It's the scorching heat. Especially nowadays, we can imagine, you know, Hajj is right in the peak of June. And you know, you go there and it's hot. And of course, you know, you're not getting your proper, you know, your needs fulfilled. And you know, you get sometimes, you know, you get angry, and then so you control yourself. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, that person, he comes back from Hajj in this state as if his mother gave birth to him today. He is clean from his sins. He is clean from his sins. No sin on his account. That's why the scholars looking at these hadith and this reward, they say that all the other narrations in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has promised the forgiveness of sins, those are related to minor sins. Those are related to minor sins, because major sins can only be forgiven by tawbah. When a person, he repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are some such deeds that a person does, he wipes out his sins. A person, he performs wudu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes out his sins. A person performs salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes out his sins. And so many other amal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes out his sins, but those are meant to be minor sins. For major sins that he commits, he has to repent. But the scholars looking at this hadith, مَنْ حَجَّ فَلَمْ يَرْفُثْ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ. Looking at this hadith and so many hadith, they say because of this Hajj Mabrur, this pious Hajj, this virtuous Hajj that he did, he's accepted in the eyes of Allah. Allah forgives his major sins as well. Because it includes, because such a hardship that he had to bear, and because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives his major sins as well. Imagine such a great journey, that all the sins that I had accumulated, and I want to bring them to be forgiven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive me. You know. So, and so many brothers, rewards on every act that we do in Hajj. So remember this, is something that we need to take advantage of. And remember this, if we have the ability, we have not performed Hajj yet, remember this, we should try to do it as soon as possible. And the reason I'm saying it now, because the Hajj applications are either they're opening or have opened already. And for those who go from North America, they know how it becomes a little tricky to apply. But alhamdulillah, this new system has been in place for a couple of years. There are brothers who know the system and we can gain their help. But remember this, we should not make an excuse. Allah has given me the ability and I fall in the category of man istata'a ilayhi sabila. I have the means and the ability to do so. Allah has given me health and Allah has given me the wealth and I can spare some time and go for Hajj. And I don't go for Hajj, my brothers, then that is a sin upon my shoulders. Who knows that I will last next year or the year after? No, I will perform it after 5 years. I will perform it when my children grow up. Or I will do it when my children get married. Brothers, who knows? You have the ability to do it right now. I will become sinful if I don't perform it. I have the ability now, then I should perform it. And yes, one of the conditions in Hajj is that the path is clear. And it is safe. Sometimes it happens, you know, you're living in a country that you're not allowed to go outside. there's a curfew or there's some restrictions on travel. Or like, you know, just a few years ago, we know, we were in COVID, we couldn't go, and so many people couldn't even go for Hajj. They only allowed the locals to do Hajj, and so the Hajj can be done. So even people had gone, so there's not a sin on them anymore. It's not part of man istata'a ilayhi sabila. But now I have all the means, and I can do it, and the path, the way is clear for me. So remember this, this is something that we need to work on from now. I have done Hajj, alhamdulillah, but I'm not free from responsibility. I should prepare others as well. I know my neighbor, I know my friend, I know my relative, I know someone in my house, and he's eligible to go for Hajj. We prepare him right away and tell him, brother, this is a time, sister, it's your time to go for Hajj. Please do not hesitate. Please do not wait. Because, remember this, the reward is tremendous, but the sin is also very big too, remember this. This is one of the pillars of Islam. Imagine a person is not praying, how much sin is he eating? He's not fasting. We consider not fasting to be a very big sin. Astaghfirullah, brother, you're not fasting. And a person doesn't go for Hajj, we're okay with it. So of course, we have to do it very politely and nicely. We find someone, we prepare him. Brother, let's go. Yeah, it's time for go to Hajj. At least apply. Do whatever you can. Whatever is in your capability and your ability, do what you can do. Especially a lot of these youngsters, remember this. No, IT workers, mashallah, they just graduated, have good jobs, mashallah. They're young, mashallah. Brother, they can do it. And honestly, remember this, if you really, looking at the aspect, this the one last aspect of, you know, taking leave from your job. Honestly, remember this, I haven't heard any, they may be, wallahu alam, but if you ask for a leave, do I have to go for pilgrimage? I'm pretty sure the jobs and the bosses and the management, they give you off. Are you going for, a virtuous pilgrimage? Oh, pray for me too, man. When you go, you pray for me. Keep us in your prayers. They will give you off, inshallah. At least I try what is in my capacity. I try. I have the means. I will submit my application. I have to go for a pilgrimage from this day to day. So please, can you give me off for that so I can start to apply now? So if you tried your best and they did not accept your application, at least you tried. But remember this, remember one thing. وَمَيِّتَّقِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah, oh Allah, I fear you that you have made Hajj fard on me. And Hajj is necessary for me. Oh Allah, I want to do it. Allah will make a way out for him. Allah will make a way out for him. So remember this is a humble request for all of the brothers who have not done Hajj yet. And they have the ability. Now is the time. Find out how to apply and how are we supposed to go for Hajj. You know, to find out how to apply, because I believe the applications, I was reading one where I think they open in September, somebody said they're opening. Whatever the case is, let's find out. At least make the effort. Find out. Alhamdulillah, the different masajid have brothers who have experiences. Find out how am I supposed to go? How am I supposed to apply? And try, remember this, as best as we can. Do not give up, remember this. We should not make excuses. Let's do it, remember this. As I mentioned right now, people make excuses, you know, that, you know, not right now, maybe later, maybe it's too hot now. Brothers, Allah will help us, you know. Allah will help us, brothers. The heat is in the hands of Allah. The weather is in the hands of Allah. You know? Allah can make it cold. Allah can make it hot. It is that I have to perform this for the sake of Allah. We fast in the month of June and July. Allah makes it easy. It's very hot outside, but still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us go through that. Alhamdulillah, those days are over. Those long days are over now. We're now in the colder days in fasting. But brothers, even this, Hajj Allah will make it easy. But we, brothers, we try. And we look around in our neighborhood, in our family, in our friends. And we know that someone, he's eligible. We try to prepare him. And brothers, then someone who is trying and who has applied, then brothers, it doesn't stop there. Then we also learn how to do Hajj properly. That Hajj has to be learned properly. The way we teach our child how to pray properly, how to fast properly, how to do so many good deeds properly, the same way Hajj, brothers, has to be learned. It's not that I just go and I see the, you know, the videos and I see people just, they're circling the Kaaba and, you know, just wear two sheets of cloth. No, remember this, there's details. The things that I have to do in Hajj, the things that I don't know, the things that I cannot see in that video. Or in that picture, you know. Some things I may think that it may be like this, but it's actually the other way around. What are the do's that I have to do and what are the don'ts, the things that I have to refrain from in Hajj? This is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No wonder how the tremendous the reward is, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking for a little sacrifice. Just do a little sacrifice and I'll give you a tremendous reward. I'll forgive you all of your sins. So we need to find out, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to do? Allah doesn't want that we just leave our desires all the way. Allah just says, just leave the desires for a little bit. Little bit, and I'll see what I give you. See what how I treat you, and I'll fulfill your desires in Jannah. Just do a little bit for me, you're my slave. So we do, we're sacrificing our desires a little bit. Those desires that we can do, we can fulfill, those needs that we can fulfill on a normal day. But if we're in Hajj, we're just sacrificing. We cannot wear our stitched clothes, we cannot apply perfume, we cannot do that just for the sake of Allah, and the reward is tremendous. So we learn every one of those things, brothers. Alhamdulillah, may Allah reward the scholars. Even in our cities, we have Hajj seminars. We attend them, we learn them. I attended once, I attend again, so I can really understand how to do Hajj. I know how am I supposed to do Hajj, so my Hajj is maqbool indallah. It is accepted in the eyes of Allah. To be very honest, remember this, so many brothers who go for Hajj, and they go so many times, and they go in the form of working in the Hujjaj, so they can make sure that they do Hajj properly. And they work with them, and they sit around with them, and they do a little, you know, reminder talk with them. You know, brother, you know, we're supposed to do this. And there's so many hujjaj. You know, when the feedback comes, it's karugudari feedback comes, and the many of the hujjaj that they meet, they're there because they were brought. We just paid the money. We came here. We don't know a single clue what to do here. And they're paying thousands of dollars to come for Hajj. And remember this, they have a single clue what to do. What are you supposed to do? What is fard here? What are the arkan? What are the fundamentals of Hajj that my Hajj will not be complete without? If I miss it, I'll have to perform Hajj again. I am not aware of it. What are the things that are wajib or necessary that if I miss it, okay, my Hajj will still be complete, but then I have to pay some ransom or I have to pay some money or slaughter an animal because of that. So what are the things that I have to do? What are the things that I am supposed to refrain from? Remember this, we learn it properly, we do it properly for the sake of Allah. I'm doing it. Remember this, everything in the dunya we learn properly. We do our job properly, we learn everything in our house properly. We know how to operate the car properly. We know how to operate the phone and the computer properly. How about the Hajj? Remember this, a hukam of Allah, which with tremendous reward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a tawfiq, the ability that all of us, Allah take off all of us again and again. And those who haven't performed, may Allah give them tawfiq, that they perform Hajj and remove all the obstacles. Any obstacles that are there in the path of Allah, remove all the obstacles and allow many youngsters. Because there are some feedbacks that some brothers, they tried, but there's some problem in the system. This happened, that happened, and eventually they're going to go. So we should ask, Oh Allah, I have the means. I want to go. I'm ready to go. I've learned it, but Allah, and remove any obstacle that is in my way, Ya Allah. Remove all the type of obstacles, whether it be spiritual obstacles, whether it be the financial obstacles, whether it be any type of obstacle, Allah, remove it. And so we can perform Hajj the way you want for us to perform Hajj. And you are pleased with us, and you forgive us, and you accept us, Ya Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-muslimin. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. A few minutes for sunnah, inshaAllah.